In this demo, you will learn how to register your personal device with Active Directory using Workplace Join. Device registration makes user devices known to IT, which makes it possible for users to access corporate resources that would otherwise not be available from their own devices. Let's start by trying to gain access to our corporate SharePoint site. You'll be prompted for your corporate credentials, so go ahead and enter your username and password. Authentication is complete, but that's not enough to access the site. The portal has been configured to require more than just your username and password. It also requires you to register your device. As you can see, you would use the modern control panel for Windows 8.1. On iOS, just follow the web link to complete the registration. So let's go back to the start screen. Swipe in from the side. Keep in mind, we are showing this on Windows, but iOS and Samsung Knox devices can perform similar tasks. Open PC Settings, next select Network, and then Workplace. Now you can complete the Workplace Join by simply entering your user credentials and clicking the Join button. The device will then communicate back to the corporate network and prompt you for credentials in order to complete the registration process. Say your company has also configured an additional level of authentication, multi-factor authentication. This requires two forms of verification. Once you have completed multi-factor authentication, your registration will be completed. Now let's try to access that resource again. Enter your credentials. Your registration is now complete, which means a certification will be installed onto your device, and a record will be created in Active Directory that maps your username and certificate thumbprint. You now have access to the resources you need. Workplace Join provides basic access to company resources, but Enrollment to Management provides even more options for users and for IT. If you are an end user and you just joined the workplace, you can easily enroll your device for management. And you can do it in the same location where you joined the workplace. Just enter your corporate credentials. That's it. Your device is now enrolled for management. In the background, Microsoft Intune will install the company portal app, which includes a curated list of corporate apps for end users to choose from. Once the company portal is installed, end users can get started installing and using their company apps. As an end user, go ahead and enter the same corporate credentials you used earlier to enroll your device for management. This will grant you access to the company portal. Here, you can see all the apps the IT department has made available to end users. End users can choose what apps they want to install. The company portal can provide apps that are installed directly on end user devices. It can also provide deep links to apps in public app stores and links to web apps. In the company portal, you can see the catalog of all the IT-managed apps and what devices you've enabled as an end user, like this iPad. As an end user, you can even take action against that device. For example, if the iPad is lost, you can reset it from any of your other devices. Well, that wraps things up. To see what else the Enterprise Mobility Suite can do, check out the rest of the videos in this series.